If you've been sketching on a tablet or an iPad, or just looking to get started on drawing more often, then this is gonna be the perfect video for you guys. Because today I'm doing an in-depth tutorial on how to create and render a fully to scale master plan in Morpholio Trace for landscape architecture. I'll be showing you the step-by-step process as well as giving you some insight to how landscape architects practice, think, design, and also build a master plan. So get out those iPads and drawing tablets and spend some time to draw with me. Now, of course, my name is Carter, and here we help future designers with landscape architectural representation, visualization, and education. So if you're looking for some more landscape architecture or design content, then check out my page for more. But with that said, let's jump right into the tutorial. Of course, you're gonna wanna open up Morpholio Trace and you'll be greeted with two options to choose from. If you have a screenshot, JPEG, PDF, or image of your background that you wanna sketch over, like a survey, floor plan, or a Google Earth screenshot, then just create a document in the size that you want your drawing to be in, and hit the picture plus icon in your layers manager to bring that in, and then just scale it down or up to fit your page. Now, if you don't have an image to draw from and you wanna just use Morpholio's built-in map system to have a base to draw on, then just hit the maps button from the start menu, navigate with the search bar to your project area, zoom into your rough outline of what your site extents are, and hit the check mark. So now either way, you should be in a good position with your new drawing, with your base draw over, and it's in the same size sheet that you would like. Now, if it's not in the right size right now, don't worry about that. We can always change it at any time along the way. From here, our next step is to quickly make sure that our toolbars are set up accordingly and to make sure that your toolbar is expanded when you do this, and then follow along with my setup. I like to use two pencils, one small and one large thickness, two pens for final drawings with a small and large thickness, an eraser, a roller brush, and a marker. Now next, we're gonna set up all of our colors for all of our drawing instruments. Now I typically only draw in black, and that's just a personal preference, but say you wanna change that and draw in a different color, then all you gotta do is make sure that your tool set is still expanded, click the color icon, and then change to a one you prefer. Now with that all the way, we should have all of our setup done and we can start actually drawing the drawing. So the first thing I always do, and what all landscape architects do, is on a new layer, draw in your site boundary with a bold red dashed line. And if there are any buildings or anything else that's existing, make a bold black border around that too. To do the border, just select your thick pen tool and change the line type to the one I have selected, which is the dashed one, and use the ruler tool to draw in your boundary. Remember that with the smart ruler activated, you can single tap the screen as you're drawing a line to allow you to draw a straight line at any angle from your point of origin. So make sure you do that for both the buildings and your existing outline, and then you'll be set up. It's important that this is your first layer in the drawing and remains the topmost layer in your drawing so that you always have a clear idea of what you're designing in, what can be changed, and what can't be changed. After you've done this, let's set up the scale of the drawing by hitting the set scale button from the wrench tool icon. Here you should find a reference point or something that is known or a fixed distance and move your two points to their extents. Type in the corresponding distance and now your scale is set. So if you don't know, things to look for is, you know, a parking lot, typically their lines are 18 feet long, or a sidewalk or a street are always good bases to go off of. So once you have all this set up, you're now ready to start drawing in some bubble diagrams, some concepts, and some sketches. Again, make sure you activate a new layer for this, and this is gonna be important. You know, one of the things you'll notice throughout my drawings and in many other landscape architects' drawing is that we create many, many layers. And you wanna be doing this as well because it gives you an opportunity to make multiple revisions without drawing over existing lines or making a mess of your workplace while still letting you see what you previously drew. So here in this first iteration, I'm showing you what a common first step of a landscape architectural drawing, which is a bubble diagram. This is typically where, as a designer, we can start to program and work out the opportunities and constraints of the project or site. So in my case, I have an urban site that is along the main street in a smaller size city and is directly next to a children's center. The site is also quite long, but not very wide, It has a real connection to the streetscape along Main Street and has a major parking lot in the back that has some serious grade change to it. So by knowing all of this and the fake clients program, I was then able to start bubbling up my areas of ideal programming for space. So this phase of the design and drawing may be 2 to 3 options in total or refining one option, but eventually you're gonna arrive at something that you like and feel confident about to proceed to the next step of your drawing. So now create another new layer and with your pencil, start to refine that bubble diagram into a simple line drawing that starts to depict the mass and the void and the circulation of your site. So here, in terms of what Morpholio is doing for you and as an app, right now we aren't really doing much with it besides using it as purely as a sketching tool. So really we're just using the pencils on a thinner or a thicker line weight and we're just roughing in what we're looking to draw and what we're looking to design. So in my case here, and by looking at the site and the shape of the plan and so forth, I decided to go with a geomorphic landscape, which is one of the few fundamental landscape forms that we most commonly use. Geomorphic form just simply means that everything is an angle and a straight line, but it's not bound to a 90 degree angle, which would make it rectilinear form. So I used that geomorphic form to construct my basic circulation patterns, connecting major paths and sight lines. Additionally, here is kind of the phase where I start to play with the scale of the spaces, the mass and void of the spaces, and test fit what amenities I want to put in which places. So typically here, I go through another round or two of revisions and then arrive at kind of a final sketch outline. And usually here for the final sketch outline, I will use the ruler tool to make my lines nice, crisp, and clean so that when I'm ready to start drawing the real drawing, it's really easy to sketch over and draw along with. And Morpholio makes it really easy to do by using the ruler tool and having the unlimited angles smart ruler activated. To do this, just make sure that when you are drawing with a ruler tool on, just tap the screen as you are drawing a straight line and it will either turn the snap on or off. But once you're ready and have a sketch that you feel confident about, it's time to start putting this thing actually together. So in Morpholio Trace and in general, I always start by drawing from the bottom up, meaning that if you looked at something in section, you start with what's on the ground plane first and then work your way up to the top, which often means that you start with your streets, walkways, sidewalks, and planter extents, which is followed by your shrubs, trees, and structures. And then you come back and finish it off by going back into the drawing to draw your fine-tuned details. It's very important that you draw in this order and to do each part on a different layer so that you can erase, clean up the drawing, and organize very appropriately from the top down without having to redraw stuff. And on that note, it's also important to talk about your pen line weights here. In design, line weight is very important and it has implications to the viewer as to what level of importance that it is. In general, on a plan view, whatever is closest to you or most important tends to be the thickest line, which is typically in the following order from large to small: site boundary, buildings and structures, trees, planters, streets, sidewalks and paths, details, and lastly, textures or hatches. If you do this correctly, your drawing will always be more easily understood and will always read very cleanly. So that said, as you can see, I've started to draw out my site circulation using a thicker line with the ruler tool. Make sure that when you are drawing out your path, to think about the width of the path, which in general, the more traffic you anticipate, the wider you want to make them. Also, a little pro tip for circulation with a geomorphic style is to try and pull from geometry that is already existing. In my case, I pulled from the building edges and the street, and then used a 30, 45, or 60 degree angle from those two edges to make a nice, clean, organized, and linear look to my site. This can be easily done again with your smart ruler by lining up your edges to match the building and then drawing accordingly. And by using the snap tool to set to a 15 degree interval, you can draw those angles in really, really easily. So here I set up my site to have 4 main spaces: the bus stop lounge area, an expansive lawn that has great sun exposure, a tucked back from the street playground that is directly adjacent to the children's center, followed by a switchback handicap accessible path and a staircase alongside that serves as the main connection from the large parking lot below the site to Main Street. Now, to further develop the space on a new layer, I started to draw in my trees, which was done by using a thicker line than what we use for the ground plane and by using the stencils that Morpholio Trace provides. Now, of course, you can always freehand these trees, but I just really like the Morpholio built-in stencils, so I went with that route. But to do that, all you need to do is select the tree icon, hit the cogwheel, and go down to some of the stencils. I prefer Varavado's stencils, and click on the one you want. In general, I recommend using a maximum of 3 different tree styles, and to use the simplest one as the biggest tree, and to save the most detailed ones for either a focal point tree or the smaller trees. From here, all that's going to be left for you to do is to draw in some fine details. So again, make sure you're creating a new layer for this. And you might have noticed by now that by creating all these layers, you might not be able to see some of them because the default layer opacities are a little bit high. So all you need to do to fix that is to go into your layer settings and turn down the paper opacity all the way down on every sheet except for the bottommost one. So that way you can see all the layers you've drawn on so far, but still have kind of a grayed out view of that Google map or survey plan. It's also a good idea at this stage, if you haven't already, to turn off your bubble diagram and sketches from earlier to just clean up the file a bit and make drawing in the details a lot easier. So now continue to draw along those details. And in my case, this was primarily furniture, a water feature, and the playground. With this approach, you can again go with the two options of freehanding or using the stencils that Morpholio has built in or you want to bring in and use those options. And if you do want to freehand it, a really cool thing that Morpholio does that I like to utilize often is to draw the detail that I'd like in my sight somewhere else and then use the selection tool that's built in, select the extents, and then you can move, resize, duplicate, anything over and over again on your site. So it makes you be able to draw in something very uniquely, but then replicate it very easily as well. This feature alone is going to save you a ton of time and is actually one of my favorite things that Morpholio can do with master plans and is a big reason of why I prefer to draw this on an iPad instead of drawing it on pen and paper. And of course, remember with your details here, you want to use a very thin line with your pen and to be conscious of how much detail you're drawing in that's appropriate to your scale of the drawing. So in my case, my plan is kind of much larger in scale, so showing immense detail isn't as important as just showing the outline and idea of spaces. But if you had something that's very zoomed in at a small scale, then drawing in as much detail would look really, really nice. So in my site, I drew in the bus stop outline, a trellis with some larger dining seating, a seat wall that is backed with our water feature that we drew in, and some movable furniture. In the lawn, I kept it simple with a few trees for shade and some movable seating. And lastly, for the playground, I drew in a small play tower with slides, a compound swing set, some playful log steps, and some smaller play amenities. And of course, we had to make sure that we drew in our steps for the staircase and the wood bridge that goes over our water feature, which connects the two spaces from the lawn and the lounge terraces. So from here, your drawing is pretty much complete. And you can either keep going with Morpholio Trace for the rendering aspect, or you can also export it as a Photoshop document that you can then color render with or bring it into Illustrator or CAD to further refine and finish the drawing. But since this is a Morpholio tutorial, let's show you how to quickly render it with an app. So my favorite tool to use for these renders is the roller brush. It's a really easy tool that you basically just surround the border with what you're trying to draw with, and it's gonna fill it in for you. Now, what makes this tool so effective is how quickly you can fill in an area and also how well it can be layered by just turning down the opacity of the brush to begin with. So before you get going on that tool, you want to make sure you choose a nice color palette to use from yourself or from Morpholio. I like to use some of the architecture palettes, but be sure to choose whatever colors you like and feel that you're going for. But once you have it all set up, you have a color palette you like, start by drawing in the colors using the exact same process as drawing in your line work. So that's starting from the ground level first, and then working your way up. And again, you wanna make sure that you do each part on a different layer, so that way the colors don't get mixed up, and you can easily manipulate and erase colors that are on top of each other for drawing clarity. Some pro tips that I recommend doing here is to fill in your ground plane all the way so that it's not see-through, but with the trees and planting, to leave that as a slightly lower opacity so that you can still read what's going on underneath in plan. Additionally, when drawing your trees, it's generally a good idea to not make them one color so they don't appear flat. I would usually use 1 to 3 very similar shades or layers on a tree that gets progressively darker in one direction to show the sun path, as well as make the drawing have some depth. It's also a really good idea as well to add in some shadows for the trees, buildings, and structures to help make them pop off the screen and show that they are higher than something else. To do this, just use a really light opacity with a black color and use either the circle guide or ruler to draw in a nice clean shadow. Of course, make sure you do this on its own layer and make sure that all of the shadows go to the same angle. So that way it all reads correctly and you can manipulate those shadows in the very end. Lastly, something that you can do depending on the scale of your drawing is to add in some textures. And you can do this by using the Smart Hatch tool, which is the second button in on the top toolbar. To use this tool, all you have to do is make sure that you have activated the layer with the region that you want to fill, and then play with the settings to set the border of that fill to your area you want to fill in. And then you can manipulate the opacity, the scale, the style, the texture, and then simply hit apply. So take your time on all of this. Don't feel rushed, but your drawing will be basically done after you finish that. The last thing and step to do is to take some time and play around with the layers, what order they're in, the opacities, and you'll get the best result for your export. So this usually means that bringing your line work and boundary back up to the top, bringing the colors back to the bottom, and then maybe playing with the drawing opacity of some of those layers to help make it read a little bit better. But from here, all you gotta do is hit the export button. So make sure that you choose whatever format and scale applies best for you in either PDF, JPEG, or Photoshop. But that is how to draw a master plan in Morpholio Trace. So I know this video was a bit long, but I wanted to make sure I did a good job and made a thorough video that explained both the step-by-step process of how to build this drawing, as well as give a little bit of insight on how architects think about designing and building something like this. So if you enjoyed this video, stuck around to the end, and found it helpful, be sure to give me a thumbs up and do all of those typical YouTube things that you guys do. Of course, if you have any questions or if there were some processes that I did that I didn't really explain well enough, then be sure to just reach out, DM, drop a comment below, and I'll do my best to answer in the best way I can. But that's gonna be all for me today. So thank you for listening and taking the time to learn some landscape architecture with me. And be sure to subscribe if you haven't. And I'll see you next time. Peace.